Tyree, the next stop on the British tour was Cornwall. I have a lot of fond memories from Cornwall, you know, it's where I first started competing and I've been there every year since. This year was no difference. Dad and I packed up the car and hit the road.
It's Halloween and we have got a scary forecast in Cornwall. We're just driving there now to the Cornwall Wave Classic and it's looking 3 days full on windsurfing and it's big. I think it's like 6 meter waves or something crazy, 15 seconds. Proper Atlantic storm. Probably the biggest of the sort of season now.
Here we are, arrived at Gwythion.
Yeah, day one, which was Friday, started off quite bad, but the idea was that it was meant to get quite good in the afternoon.
Clearing in the sailing area. Please do not do that. All right.
We were just playing the wetting game, hanging around, not doing much, but good to catch up with a few people.
Everyone's interested in the 60.
Gonna go and get changed. No one else is. One person's gone out. I'm getting withdrawal symptoms in this car, so I just need to get in the water.
Job for the day.
It was also really cool to meet up with Jack and James, sort of the original grommets. We used to do training camps together when we were younger, so it was really cool to meet back up with them. The goats track, yeah, it's basically the shortcut to Gwythion. It's super sketchy, super slippery.
It's a bit of adrenaline before the session.
You can remember each other, you didn't have to walk way around there.
Yeah.
To conclude, day one was a bit of a washout. You know, we got some fun conditions, but we all packed up to get ready for the big day on Saturday.
Heavy rain, but really strong winds pushing into parts of southwest England.
I just remember sleeping that night in the house we were staying in, like, just felt like it was gonna fall down. It was so windy. And yeah, we arrived at Marazan Beach and it was just ridiculous when we got there.
Basically, we're gonna start as soon as the tide drops because it's too high tide now. And oh, it is just crazy out there. The waves luckily aren't ridiculous, but the wind is for sure is ridiculous. Really doesn't do it justice, but yeah, we've got 3-0 rigged. Just gotta survive.
Put the impact vest on, so I've got no excuses now, I've got to send it.
I don't know, there were so many things going through my head before the heat. I was at the beach getting everything ready and looking at the conditions and, well, on one hand it was slow attack, so at least that made me feel quite confident. Yeah, I just really wanted to prove myself after the poor result in Tyree. Had a bit of a shock when I went out to test the conditions. As I launched, I didn't even comprehend how windy it was and I just got blown off my feet straight away. And then just had a horrible crash where I was out of control, so yeah, not the best start ever. I really was quite shaken up after that and I really had to put my head down and I was thinking, like, am I even going to be able to sail, am I even going to be able to compete? I just had to get in the zone and just think I can do this. I don't think I sailed to my full potential, but I don't think anyone else really did on that day with the conditions. But I passed the heat and I was into the next round. Would have been in a bit of trouble if Jamie had landed that big stall board, but luckily for me, he crushed it. A lot of good sailors were going down hard that day. It was extreme, heavy conditions. Like any other day would have been survival, but to compete in that was mental. At least now the pressure was off a bit, so I could just go and have fun. Just trying to have fun, but when it came to it, I really, really wanted to get into that final.
Probably be on the water more, but South Case is the windiest at the moment.
And I'm a bit thick. Been,
yeah. James Cox, Lucas Meldrum, Andy King, Ben Page.
Oh, Lucas, legend. Oh, thank you very much. Told you the table.
First final, mate.
Oh, no way. Sick, good job, mate.
In a final, Lucas.
That's a surprise.
When I found out I got to the final, it was pretty crazy. I didn't expect it, to be honest. I was a bit speechless, but I just wanted to put it all together in the final and sell a really good heat.
You've got the big guns now, Phil, Jamie.
It's like a dream.
It's next, isn't it? I mean, it was a heat break.
Yeah, I was feeling good, I was feeling ready, and then just as the heat started, the wind died. I had to come in and get my bigger sail. And I don't know if it was because of that or something else, but I never really got into my rhythm and had a bit of a shocker, really. If you don't sail your best at this stage of the competition, you know, you're up against Phil and Jamie, who are both World Cup sailors, and Coxie, who's an amazing style attack sailor, you've really got little chance. I was pretty bummed on how I sailed, but it was still an achievement for me coming fourth.
So, in fourth place, guys, we have Lucas Meldrum.
Well done. Congrats.
It was also really nice to hear how people and other pros said how well I sailed.
Pays off, huh?
Yeah. You're the lightest man on the water sailing that well today.
Oh, it's all up.
Oh, mate.
Yeah.
Hard work. Well done. That was incredible.
I still had the double elimination on Sunday and I had a good result to improve.